Okay, so brother, tell me why you're here.
Obviously, we're here to protest against this man, Geert Wilders, who insulted the messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We're here to give him a message that, like he's doing in his interview today, hold up. He'll remain hold up, because obviously he knows that in Islam, the punishment for the one who insults the Prophet is capital punishment. And he should take lessons from people like Theo van Gogh and others who face the punishment. So obviously we're here to warn him and remind him that he's going to remain hold up as long as he insults Islam and Muslims.
But is that going to be construed as a threat, what he just said?
Well, obviously, what I'm saying, I'm not saying I'm personally I'm going to carry out, but he needs to know that there's Muslims in every corner of the earth. And these people, they all have love for the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said that man sabba la nabiyyuk faqtuluhu. He said the one who insults any of the prophets, kill him. That is the capital punishment. Not necessarily that I personally I'm going to carry out, but he should be warned that, you know, the consequences of it.
Do you consider this a victory today that you prevented him from speaking?
Well, obviously, I think all those people who insulted Islam, they're under constant protection anyway. They don't live a life. So they should learn from that and not insult the Messenger of Allah.
All right, thank you. Stuck, okay.
My dear Muslims, and for the non-Muslims, we are here to teach this dog a lesson that he wishes to bark in Holland and insult the Messenger and insult Islam and the Muslims. But when it comes to the UK, he meets the lions of Tawheed, the Muslims that won't stand for this rubbish. They want to say that he's an extremist. They want to say that he's not representing their views. But this dog is the open voice of democracy. We can see that what he says is in the hearts of every government in Europe. We can see that everything that he says is in the heart of every disbeliever. That he wishes to ban the hijab. That he wishes to take away the Quran. That he wants to close down the Islamic centers. That's the same thing that we see in the rhetoric of the British media. Just the other day, in the Daily Mail, they had a vote to see if they wish to ban the hijab. This is the same rubbish. This is the same thing that we hear from this dog, Wilders. But if he goes, wherever he goes, let him know that Islam will come. Islam will dominate. Islam will dominate the east of the east and the west of the west. So no matter where he runs, this dog, Islam will be implemented. So he can go and crawl under any rock. That he can go and crawl under any rock he wants in Europe. But no, Islam will come and it will conquer the UK. It will conquer Holland. It will conquer Rome. It will conquer the world. Islam will enter the house of every person on this world, and it will either elevate the person or will humiliate the person. And we will see the believers victorious. We will see Israel destroyed. We will see the European crusaders destroyed, and we will see Islam dominate.
The Muslims are gathered here today because the guy at the back, Geert Wilders, has insulted the Prophet and insulted the Quran. And as we know, the Muslims, the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever insults the Prophet, faqtiluhum, kill him. So we are here to let the people know that we are not going to stand for this no more. That we are here to let the people know that the British, the UK, are hypocrites. Yet they prosecute the Muslims for incitement and racial hatred. And yet he says so many things against Islam, and he says so many things about Quran, and nothing happens to him, and he gets granted to come into the UK. So we're not going to stand for it here no more. We have come here to let the people know that this is no more. So we let the whole world know that we need him. And if we had an Islamic State today, his head would be on the stake.
Yeah, you see, Geert Wilders, the things that he said was anti-Islam, anti-Muslim. And this is not something new. The British government and the Dutch government and all of these governments are in an alliance together, killing Muslims in Iraq and Afghanistan. So this is nothing new. What we say to him is, let him come outside. How is it that this man is now scared? He's running scared, he can't come out of the buildings. And the police and the government are here supporting him and protecting him from the Muslims. Geert Wilders, the message to him is to come outside and face the Muslims. Come outside and feel how the Islamic punishment should be on him is obviously one, only one. and he's so scared. Where did all the freedom go? And where did all the democracy and everything? Let him come outside. Let the police go home. 2 minutes, and see how he's faced with the Islamic view on all of this. What he said.